driving under the influence. The key word to that is influence. You can blow a .00000 and get a DUI. You also do not have to be driving a motor vehicle. You can be riding your bicycle. Some states you can be riding a horse. Or as one guy found out, you can be riding your riding lawnmower.
You can be arrested for a DUI even if you are not driving. If you have actual physical control of a vehicle while under the influence, then that can be enough for an officer to arrest you. Generally, actual physical control means that the driver is in the vehicle and could make it move. In California, however, you could be convicted of a DUI even if you had no intention of making the vehicle move. Having the potential ability to do so, even if you are asleep in a parked car when the officer finds you, can satisfy the meaning of actual physical control. This is not a DUI class, it's a responsible beverage service training program class, but alcohol consumption leads to alcohol-impaired driving, which causes slowed reaction time, reduced or decreased vision, impaired judgment, and reduction in concentration and coordination, which can lead to a whole lot of bad is going to happen. All law enforcement agencies in California work for the end result of two words, which is public safety. It all starts with the implied consent law. The implied consent law is this. A person who drives a motor vehicle is deemed to have given his or her consent to chemical testing of his or her blood or breath for the purpose of determining the alcoholic content of his or her blood, if lawfully arrested for an offense allegedly committed. Refusing to take the test. Once you are arrested, the officer should warn you of the penalties for refusing a chemical test. If you refuse, your license will be revoked. Also, depending on your driving history, you could be prohibited from driving while there is any measurable amount of alcohol in your system for 5 to 10 years. Additionally, you might have to have an ignition interlock device installed in your car for 3 years. The major consequences of a chemical test refusal in California are 1. Increased penalties in addition to the standard California DUI penalties, and 2. A mandatory driver's license suspension that will occur regardless of the outcome in your DUI case. When 50% of all DUIs come from people drinking in on-premise licensed locations, the state of California has to act to fulfill the commitment to public safety.